In this video, you will learn the design of reinforced concrete circular columns. The given condition is shown. We have a slab that's a circular platform supported on circular columns whose strength of material is given. The floor height is 10 feet. It is a single story structure. The slab is of 8 inches. Live load is 40 psf. Super dead load is 20 psf. And the layout is shown. We have to design for gravitational loads, calculate column sizes, design the reinforcement, and detail the column drawing on AutoCAD. First of all, assuming minimum dimension, the dimension of column as 8 inches diameter, which is the least diameter of concrete column. Let's define the size of the column with 1 inch increments. So first of all, we will have to define the grids and then material, then we will go to column cross section defined. Since it has single story, so we define it as single story. The materials were already defined. I will go toward defining the frame sections. Delete the useless properties which we would not be using. So add new property of circular concrete column. Let's take it as C8 as it has 8 inches diameter. I will specify the diameter, the stiffness modifiers. So it's a concrete column which has ties, reinforcement to be designed. Similarly, C10. So we are varying diameters every time we are increasing 1 or 2 inches. That Etabs will calculate the size of the column by itself. Select concrete here. Let's name it as auto select cross section. Add it into the list. Delete this property. Okay. Now defining the modifiers of this slab as 0.25 according to ACI code. The slab given dimension was 8 inches. I will be requiring circular grids. So add new grid system, cylindrical, global X and Y 0. In order to understand the details of cylindrical grids with examples, see video whose link is given in description. Right now, I'm supposing we have watched that video, so I'm defining the grids according to the condition given. In T direction, specifies the grids as we are having 8 columns. Spacing of grids in R direction is 20 feet. While we need to add the another outer dimension of 1 foot, which we will be adding. You can download the fully functional scientific calculator from the link given in the description. So 360 is the complete circle angle divided by 8 lines, we'll get 45 degrees. So we have to specify 1 foot grid as well from the previous grid distance. Drawing the columns. Now you need to draw the slab. Since we have to draw a circular slab, then we will have to use a modeling technique here. First of all, just drawing a rectangular randomly slab, but it has to cover the area where the circular slab has to be drawn. Now select the point and extrude the joint to frames. Now we go to radial extrusion. First we have to select the center point about which the circle is to be drawn, and then we enter the angle by which each line will turn from the previous line, and the number of lines is 360. So it's a circle formed. Now we will have to delete the slab outside this circle. First of all, turning visibility off of the columns and the joints. Now we go to edit frames and divide shells. Basically, cookie cut option is better. So it's gonna take a while as it's a heavy model because of this slab meshing. We have to hide this section and delete the rest. So it's already hidden. I will be deleting this section. Now show all the objects, that is the slab which we hidden. Now defining the load pattern starting with superdel, that is SDL. Let's say it is superdel. Add new load. Assign the load to the slab. Let's say this has 40 PSF and the SDL is 20 PSF. Checking the loads assigned. Now we have to make the bottom supports as fixed. Now let's start with the design parameters. Specifying the code which we have to use for design. Turn off the visibility of the floors. Hide the joints. Select the columns, that is the part of frame members, and go to sway intermediate, as we have not been specified that is the special earthquake condition. So our case is not to design these special seismic joints. We will take it as intermediate moment resisting system. Now let's see, it is the structure. Basically these kind of structures you will find in monobands, hotels. Or even in parks. So So we will select concrete frame design combinations. And let's click on the run. So then we click on design. So the members are overstressed even on the highest cross section which we specified. The members are overstressed. I will define the frame or column sections which are heavier than the existing sections, as the existing sections failed to resist the applied loads. Actually, we didn't change the diameter. So, yeah, now we have added it into the auto select list. Now we will have to rerun the model. As designing is an iterative process, you'll have to do iterations so that you finally get the cross sections which are adequate to resist the applied loads. So sometimes the Etabs says that this analysis model did not convert the solution, so we have to rerun. Now you see the steel shown. Let's check the rebar percentage whether it's placeable on site or not. So the percentage is less than 6%, but it's heavily reinforced. Practically, we select a percentage in the column not more than 4%, as it's difficult to execute on the site. Let's make the bottoms fix again, as it reiterated the solution. And let's see if the steel decreases after making the bottom supports fix. So the steel is still, however, the same in terms of percentage. It is above 5%. The section used is C14. I'd rather prefer using C18 with lesser reinforcement, as it's difficult to place such amount of steel on site. So I'd prefer concrete resisting my loads compared to steel heavily reinforced columns. So I'll override the column sizes as 18 inches, which I have already defined. So now the percentage of steel is to be checked. Let's see, it's around 2-3%. Now check the highest rebar percentage. That's since the columns are symmetrical in respect to resistance of the load. So let's check how much number of bars we are required to place in the column. So we are getting 5.69 inches square, let's say 5.7 inches square of steel in cross section of the column. So let's use number 7 bars. The area of number 7 bar is 0.6. So we are getting 10 bars. Let's try with number 8 bars. The area of number 8 bars is 0.785. So the total area of steel is 5.69 divided by 0.785, that is the number of single number 8 bar. So we are getting 8 number 8 bars. Let's detail the column and number 8 bars. So in the next video I will be designing this circular slab. So subscribe to the channel so that you get update when I'll upload that video. Now we have to add the shear reinforcement for this slab, for the column. So we have to check the units of shear reinforcement, as we need it in inch square per inch. Now we'll put the reinforcing in the formula of 2 times number of legs times the area of tie bar divided by Etabs output. As we are using number 3 ties, so I have taken 2 legs of number 3 ties divided by Etabs output. So we are getting a spacing of 16 inches. Let's check the ACI limitations for IMRF ties. The spacing of ties at column end shall not be greater than 8 times diameter of the smallest longitudinal bar, 24 times diameter of the tie, half of the smallest column cross sectional dimension. L0 shall not be less than column span divided by 6, maximum column dimension 18 inches. The spacing of ties shall not be greater than twice of outside. But since IMRF conditions will not apply, as we are not designing it for earthquake, so using typical arrangements, hence the tie spacing shall not be greater than 16 inches, as we are using main bar of number 8 and the ties of number 3. The table was taken from a book of structure engineering. Let's label the diameter of the column. You may sometimes apply the conditions of IMRF to only gravity designed columns, as it is a detailing requirement, but since it's not a critical structure, so I'll keep it that way, as concrete is enough to resist that low amount of shear. So we may also check for the K value of the columns taken by Etabs, but it is not important to check manually. We can check it from Etabs. We have to use conservative value of K as 1. So the K factor value is 1. We can also display the value of K factor from this design input option. You can see all the columns are taken 1. Subscribe to the channel. In the next part of the video, I'll discuss the circular slab design for the same structure which is shown.